Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. Today we continue our music theory series right here at BusyWorksBeats.com/music theory. Now, film score is a lot easier than you think, and that's because companies like East West have spent millions of dollars sampling the highest quality sounds you can get, so you don't have to go hire an orchestra to go sit in a studio and record what you need recorded. Now, that still goes on to a degree, but now you have the power of an orchestra right in front of you in your computer. It's insane. So I'm going to use East West's Play plugin. We're going to load up some instruments. This is from Composer Cloud, the new Composer Cloud. I had Composer Cloud before, but it was re-gifted to me through East West as an extension of East West through Martina. So thank you, Martina, and thank you, East West. So I'm going to show you libraries that I didn't have in my stash. Before, I had the Hollywood Diamond Bundle. I bought that one, and I had Composer Cloud before. So real short, Composer Cloud is a monthly thing, and it basically allows you to use most, if not all, the libraries. I'm not sure which ones are kept out, but you can add more libraries. So this is not all the libraries. You can even add another product library right inside your installation center. Long story short, you have a bunch of libraries, and you can see which sounds you actually like, and then from there, you can invest in the library itself. So after I found out the Hollywood Diamond Bundle was what I wanted, I bought it. Okay, so that's how it works. So let's load up some sounds. Now, they've made a lot of updates ever since I had Composer Cloud. So one is the database. You can now search sounds. Now, this sounds like a menial thing, but you know, when you're coming from a company like East West who has thousands and thousands of sounds, you probably don't know which library to start with. So I'm glad they added this database and a search function so we can click here. Now, another thing I just noticed, you can click installed, which means only the sounds you've installed to your computer. Because you can look through all their sounds, like if you want a brass hit or something, let's just type in brass hit, see what pops up. Nothing, because I was too specific. But if you type in brass, okay, all this stuff pops up. You click on a sound, it tells you the library it's from right here. I don't know if I have all these libraries activated. So what I want to do is only look through the sounds I have. So let's go to installed, okay, and type in staccato. Okay, and I can pull up a staccato sound. Trumpet staccato, flute staccato. I don't know what these stand for. Three trumpet. Okay, so that's from the diamond. So let's go to flute staccato. Wonder what that sounds like. Let's add that in. Okay, and I'm going to use a lot of search functions to look for sounds. Now, if you're like me, I don't have a ton of experience, you know, as an orchestral player, as a musician who played in the orchestra. I just didn't have that luxury. So, you know, all this stuff is foreign to me to a degree. I'm not saying it's super foreign, but basically I look at it like different synth sounds or different sound wave textures, like a pulse wave or a sawtooth wave. Certain things just have certain characteristics. So what we're going to do is build out a chord progression. I don't want staccato. I want sustained sounds. I forget what I clicked last time. So instead of me guessing, what I'm going to do is click installed. I'm going to go to any. So it refreshes all the options. And let's go to types. We want strings. Wait, types looks a little specific. Oh, here we go. Category. Okay, ethnic strings, or we can do orchestral strings. I think I want orchestral strings. We can narrow it down. So let's say you want what else do they have? Full strings. I want a full ensemble, orchestral style. Okay, and what timbres do we want? Bright, do we want heavy? I want ethereal, which is like dreamy. Oh, I don't have that library, I guess. So let's go back. Let's just start from here. We have enough options. Okay, so a lot of these are different playing styles. So you see LEG, which stands for legato. Round robin is double R. I don't know what all these stand for, but you know, it's like the little nuances of knowing about playing the instrument itself. Long story short, just click on something and get started. Okay, don't let the little things confuse you for a long amount of time, because then we could obsess over minutia for no reason. Okay, so as this loads up, I found one before that was like a 30-piece orchestra. I forget which sound it was. It was from the library called Silk. I think it was in China. I forget where I found it, but it was a nice string. I forget where it's at. So that's where the database comes into play, and you can favorite sounds. So if you like a sound, you just favorite it. Boom. And now you can search through your favorites only, or your installed, or your licensed stuff. So really helpful. Because before it just had a bunch of sounds. So as this loads, so film score is about simplicity. It's not about like ninth chords and all these jazzier things. It's really about like triads and very simple chords and resolving those chords. So film score is more about resolving your music than it is super complex stuff. So for example, you might hear this chord being played. Now it seems like I have a flute. Oh, that's just that octave. Okay, cool. Okay, so I'm just playing three notes, but it sounds like a movie. That's because movie chords are less, like, luxurious. So for example, not luxurious, but less lush. They may play a ninth chord. That's a ninth chord. Maybe for like a jazzier scene, maybe like a 007 kind of out on the night type of scene. So there's a lot to, you know, go through, but you want to simplify it. Okay, so what are we trying to do? Create film score. For what genre of thing? Just a general trailer sound. So we want tension and release, okay? Every good story has a bad guy most of the time, if it's a hero story. So we're going to create chords which are become the bad guy, so to speak, and create tension. First, pick your key. We're not going to get too complex with this video, but let's just do... So always remember, a scale is the note sequence that you like. That's all a scale is. What notes do you like and in what order? That's all a scale is. There are a bunch of scales. So let's start by identifying the root note. Now there's a lot of music theory to go over, but we're just going to create a simple sound. I'm just going to focus on creating tension and then resolve. It's basically all I'm going to focus on today. So for the first chord, we're going to use the root note so it allows people to identify the key of our song. It's just an identifier. Okay, so we're going to start here. Skip every note going up your scale. So C, skip D, go to E flat, skip F, go to G. Very simple chord, not complex. Okay, let's move this over. It's just a reference. So we're going from the... Now, again, I'm kind of skimming over stuff because it's not enough time to explain everything in one video. That would take forever, okay? We have courses on that right at busyworksbeats.com. Music theory courses specifically, okay? So, for example, we're starting on the 1 of the scale. In this case, we're going to try a 1, 6, 4, 5. So we're going to go 1, 2. Now, I'm not going to say 1 because that can confuse you with chord code. So let's call this the first. Technically, it is the first scale degree, not the one. It's a scale degree. So it's a first, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth. So now we're going to go up to G sharp, and that's going to become our root note. Now, also in film score, we use a lot of inversions. It depends on the context of the chord. So, for example, if your chords make a random jump, like, you know, however many semitones up, you want to kind of blend it in with the one before. You know, it's kind of like having super hot water and then super cold water combined. It feels kind of weird to have two opposites. So if you make some kind of in-between warm water, it's more pleasing. So we're doing that in chord language. So here's our first of that chord. Skip the notes going up the scale. Again, I'm leaving out a lot of language and a lot of technique because it's just way beyond the scope of the video. We have courses on this. Full courses on just melody. Full courses on just chord progressions. Full courses on the circle of fifths and fourths and the secrets behind them. There's a lot of, you know, courses there, scale courses, etc. Right at busyworksbeats.com. So we're going to skip B flat, go to C. Skip D, go to E flat. So we have C. I don't know if I like that flute, so I'm probably going to switch to the library, but it's going to take a little bit. So let's go to browser, strings, and I don't remember this many options before. What was I clicking on before? I was in these lower options, so... For whatever reason, it repopulated. I must have clicked something else. So let's load up the 50 piece string section sustain. So these are different playing styles. Fast, legato, sustain. We want sustain, so the notes are held. Oh, you know why. We didn't... Okay, I'm slow. That's because it wasn't installed, that's why. Okay, but I can always go in and get that library. And it's at no extra cost. It's just, I forget how much space you have. I don't know if you have access to all the sounds. I have to go look. But Composer Cloud, I have a hard drive that comes with it with like a terabyte of space, so I can download all the libraries that can fit on that hard drive. It's just easy to keep them all in one place. Okay, let's see. Orchestral strings. Let's load this bad boy up. Now this is more of a general string library. So what I would do to blend this in is pull this down an octave. So that means this note and this note are the same and they're close together. It creates a little bit of a blend rather than just this being an octave up. And it creates more of a, or excuse me, less of a change to the ear. So it's not so dramatic. So it's first, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth. Then we're gonna go fourth, which is F. There are different style chord progressions. There's no hard rule for anything, okay? But the last thing we're gonna do is land on the fifth. And that's because going from the fifth to the first, or the tonic, creates a lot of tension, or excuse me, a lot of resolve, okay? So let's go from here, G, and then B flat, D, and then we have F, A flat, and C. So you could leave it this way, or you could even transpose that note up an octave. So all these notes are more in the same range, whereas this note is kind of far away from this note. But there's no rule. And then it resolves, okay? So with film score, again, it's all about resolving things. So let's add a little bit of tension in here. So we're going to end on that. So with, okay, there's so much to teach, but I'm trying to like give you something to take away. So firstly, in film score, you can put off the resolution of a song. So you can have a song be really, really tense all the way through and then resolve at the end. So let's do that here in a small little time frame instead of writing out a full song. So we're gonna go first, sixth, fourth, and then we can do some kind of variation of the fourth. So in this case, we can add an augmented chord or suspended fourth or suspended second chord. Now there are chord codes for this. This is why I said there's so much to this training. So go to busyworksbeats.com. Basically, you know, we can go outside of the scale to add certain chords in here using number, which are not listed in our scale. So we have to go outside the scale to grab those chords. And you can use chord codes to do that. So it's 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That's an augmented. Now it may sound bad here. You can use diminished. You could try a lot of things. Let's just try augmented. So that creates tension. Why? Because this note is not in the scale. Neither is this note. Okay? There, I'm getting tongue twisted because I just took my braces out, but there are a lot of ways to create tension. And a lot of people, here's what the problem is with traditional music theory teaching, is that everybody teaches to the scale and you have to memorize the scale. What happens when you have to go outside the scale? You get super confused. It's because people don't train you the right way. We train you in a new way at busyworksbeats.com, how to approach music theory. So you can use chord codes to get started. If you have no idea what music theory is, chord codes are great to get in the game of music theory. Then from there, you can learn, okay, I can go outside the scale. I can create chords that are not in this particular scale, but it sounds right. Now here I want a lush chord, so just to kind of take this to the next level, let's make this the seventh chord. Now also, there's a lot of language that I have to go over. You want to double check. So here's the power of chord codes as well. Sometimes your scale will force you to create a chord that's not a major or a minor. That's another thing about scales that throws you off in school. They don't teach you this stuff. So it's 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So that's not going to sound cool. I already know because of chord codes. So 7, 8, 9, 10. 7, 8, 9, 10. That's going to make the minor 7 chord code. Unless it looks like I just skipped a note. That's why. Oh, I skipped to the wrong one. Either way, you can start problem solving with chord codes as well. It's not just a way to get started. It's a way to solve problems. So this is a ninth chord here. So I'm going to take tension and then bring it into a super lush beginning. All I'm doing here is extending these chords. We go over this at busyworksbeats.com. So everything that I'm kind of leaving out, I go over in depth. I'm not doing that on purpose. It's just too much to go over in 2 seconds. Okay, so let's grab F. Now here it got chaotic. Let's see why. It's probably because one of these numbers in the chord is not of a chord code, or it creates dissonance. So here's 0, 1, 2, 3. We know that's the beginning of a minor chord. 4, 5, 6. Okay, so that lets us know this is a diminished chord. And a diminished chord sounds horrible, in my opinion. So I don't want a diminished chord. So I'm going to take this 6. The reason I'm calling it 6 is because it's a semitone system. And you can't use whole tones when you're sound designing. So, you know, our system goes over pure number and why chords are pure number. So I'm going to take that 6, pull it to a 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. This should be 14 to make that a minor 9. So you can problem solve with chord codes. Then I'm going to go... Dun. Okay, so let's work backwards here. Take E flat, skip every other note going down. So we have E flat. Now, did I skip a note? Wait, G. Yeah, I skipped a note. Then it resolves at the end. So you can create a little more tension here with that 5 chord. Let's add a little tension here. So we're taking this note from before, adding it over here. It's a little chaotic, probably too chaotic. So instead of creating a lot of tension, we're going to let it resolve. So the tension would come in this chord, if any chord. But I like the way it sounds. No need to overly do it. Now again, there's more to music theory. I'm showing you like a small window of the whole thing of music theory. I went over our core concepts, but there's a lot more to it. Just go to busyworksbeats.com. So with film score, it's all about that resolution. So the 5th to the 1st created that resolution. And you can push that off towards the end of your chord progression. Okay, so there's a lot to learn about chords and chord progressions and all these things. No plugin is going to do this for you. There's no plugin that tells you, you know, how to create an emotion. It tells you which chord. It's so funny, these companies. Now it's no shade. I don't know if East West has a, like, music theory plugin or whatever. But there's no plugin that's going to tell you what feels right as a human. They can tell you the 1, 6, 4, 5 chord progression, but that's, as humans, we want to make so many changes to it. We want to have options. Long story short, go to busyworksbeats.com to learn how to create options for yourself and custom make your chord progressions. Thanks for watching today. It's busyworksbeats.com.